In the energy quadrant, taking a look at the August crude oil futures contract, WTI crude dropped for a second consecutive session, resulting in a total drop of 0.92% over those two sessions. Crude has now dropped about 2.54% since the July 3rd swing high close of 83.88 and 6.7% since the 2024 swing high hit on April 5th. A high today, 82.58, was up about 45 basis points, so a little less than a half of 1%. The low today, 81.47, that was down 0.9%, so just short of a full percentage point. And as we come into the close, we're still down about a half of 1%. China's GDP disappointed, up 4.7%. It was expected at up 5.1%. And the last print was up 5.3%. So China's oil demand has been slowing since the start of 2024. Imports of crude oil have trended lower than expected since the start of this year. And while it could be argued expectations may have been unrealistic in the first place, the decline is affecting the outlook for total global demand. This GDP number surely does not change the expectation for further declines in China's oil demand, so some of the weakness can be explained by that. Also, the number of rig counts fell by one this week after holding steady the previous week. Oil rigs now stand at 478, down by 59 compared to this time last year. But despite this, U.S. crude oil production rose by 1 million barrels per day to 13.3 million barrels per day for the week ending July 5th. So that's according to the EIA. So the current weekly production is now on par with the all-time high of 13.3 million barrels a day. So again, a little bit of a headwind for WTI crude oil in that data.